7:15 in the morning of Monday the 25th of November. It's still dark outside. Hello, winter. The big winter coat is on. The light is coming in the sky. I'm on a GWR train heading west, just left Slough, heading to Reading to put some purple into my life. So today's mission is quite simple. A few weeks ago, maybe a few months ago now, several headlines online that said that TfL Rail services between Paddington and Reading would commence on Sunday, December the 15th, i.e. purple trains out all the way to Reading, likely to appear on the tube map. That was the date, mid-December. Until word got out and it was confirmed that today they might be running six services a day, slightly early, as like a warm-up. So we're gonna go and see if we can be on the very first one. It's on the board, 7:32. It's doing that trick where it says it's only going to Ealing Broadway, but we all know it's going to Paddington. Platform 15. There's clearly some staff on board. There we go, that's your first purple train. Pulling in with all the TfL Rail logos, even though it's actually a GWR service, we will discuss this on board. It's still GWR for the next 3 weeks. Pulling in on platform 15.
We have now announced this train on platform 15. It's using public service. It's the first one that's come in a funny colour.
Did you say funny colour? It's not a funny colour, it's a delightful purple. There's a definite mix of bewildered passengers and people who knew it was coming. And I've just got enough time to run down the front and get a picture.
This is a TfL Rail service to Paddington. Next station, Twyford.
Now there were some confused looking commuters this morning when they got off expecting their normal GWR green train and they said they got a purple one. One of those was Kieran. Where are you going?
Morning. Good morning.
This is Kieran. This is normally a green GWR train. Were you confused when you got on this morning? What happened?
I was confused and quite surprised, yeah.
Okay, now you're going to Southall, you say?
Yeah.
And the test will be, is that you're saying this is...
Yeah, so...
It's quite busy by Southall.
Oh yeah, it's completely packed.
So it'll be interesting to see will this be as packed or yeah.
Yeah, because there seems to be a lot more standing room than this one.
Less seats I think, but more standing room. Okay. Twyford.
Next station, Maidenhead.
There's a man I recognise. Daniel, nice shirt. Why are you wearing that? Dan's turned up.
All the better for being on a purple train.
All the better for being on a purple train. That, you get that on a t-shirt.
A lot of these people getting on here will be off at Slough or Langley. Or West Drayton.
Obviously not going to Paddington,
no.
Morning.
How'd you like your new train?
Yeah.
Right, so my ticket's only to Slough on purpose because I want to bounce back and get some other stations. So Kieran, have a great day.
You too.
Jeff.
Chris, yes. Here. See you later. Enjoy. On the return. Dan, you're going to be my test control.
I am.
And I'll see you on the way back.
Yes.
You tell me how busy it got.
I will.
And I'm going to bow here at Slough.
Right, yeah.
See you in a bit.
Yeah, see you later.
All right. So I want to check out some of the stations in between Slough and Maidenhead. So I've bowed at Slough on purpose because I want to see I'll get another train down to either like Taplow or Burnham and pick up the return to Reading on the way back. I want to see how purple it is, see if the stations have been purplified. Except I kind of already know the answer,
they won't be purplified properly until December the 15th, which is when all day TfL Rail services start. If you're confused as to what this is, what's going on is that this is a Crossrail train, what TfL call Elizabeth Line, what I call the Purple Train. On December the 15th, TfL Rail take over the stopping services that GWR run, except for some in the peak, but definitely all the off-peak services will become Purple Train services. But they're running like a preview now, just six trains. It allows GWR and TfL to get their stock, their trains into position, and just warm up and maybe just sort of break the general public into the fact that they're now riding Purple Trains. The Purple Trains, this morning by the way, that was a 7-car train. They will in future be 9-car. But the GWR trains that they replaced did have toilets, did have table seats, did have plug sockets. The Purple Trains don't have that, but what they do have, of course, is more space because there's more standing room. So that train will get really busy as it gets to like West Strait and onwards, stopping at Ealing Broadway and Southall, going into London Paddington. So it will be interesting to hear. Dan, as my correspondent, will let me know just like, did it soak up the passengers or not? I've got about an hour here in Slough. I shall get some breakfast and then get a train heading back to Reading.
A Great Western Railway service to Reading.
Yeah, the next stop is Burnham. I want to pop down and see how purple-fied it's become. Like, is there any TfL branding? Have they put any tube maps out on the racks? I just spent the half an hour in the Tesco Extra at Slough having my breakfast with my purple pen, cheekily drawing in purple lines out to Reading, because come December, TfL, I assume, hello, will put TfL Rail on the tube map, so they'll be like they'll squeeze it in. What's more interesting is the bigger paper fold-out map which you get, which looks like this. And on here, it's interesting to note that this map here, where TfL Rail goes out to Shenfield out east, it means that the central area, if you look at like the bottle shape of the circle line, that is slightly left of centre of this whole map to allow all the railway to the right, to the east of the map, to be squeezed in on. On the left-hand side, it very clearly gets chopped off at West Drayton. So somehow, are they? They're gonna have to squeeze in the branch to Reading there. So that'll be interesting, not just the TfL map of services tube map, but how this, I believe they're calling it London's Rail and Tube Services map, how that will look in December. So keep an eye out for new tube maps and London Rail and Services maps with TfL Rail added come December. Remember, until December the 15th, they're just TfL trains running GWR services, and then they do take over the GWR services all day off peak and then in the peak, but there are still some GWR stoppers in the peak as well. So there will still be some non-purple trains, but this one I'm on now, this is a 387 with the table seats and the toilets. This is what the purple trains are replacing. So I'm at Burnham, off camera I'm speaking to a lovely member of staff. She said that here there was that beautiful moment which all commuters do here at Burnham this morning, where the purple train rolled in and there was visible confusion on people's faces. They were like, "What? Is this our train?" Because some people like to sit in the same seat in the same spot every day. And there's a poster here that says introduction of TfL Rail services, and the big day it's saying is Sunday the 15th of December. So that's when it all happens. Until then, there are just six a day, three in the morning and three in the evening. I will run through the times shortly, but it's coming next. This is the 9:16 to Reading, and Dan will be on it and we'll go back to Reading. Thank you. I'm down in the ticket hall area of Burnham. There's no maps up. There is this poster saying about the services. There's two Oyster pads, except they don't accept Oyster. It's going to be contactless only, so sorry, not in use. A new asset is coming, because this will be, see this video here, for how everything beyond West Drayton is going to be bank contactless cards, but not Oyster in terms of pay as you go. You can still use paper tickets as normal. But the display board, I notice, is a TfL Rail style board. So I can't find any tube maps though. I was hoping for a rack with timetables and tube maps. I was going to put all my tube maps with all the purple lines I've added in on the tube racks, but I can't find it. Finally, I've seen a sign that is correct, because down there it says it's TfL Rail. Up on the dot matrix it says it's TfL Rail, but on the more traditional displays it says it's a GWR service operated by TfL Rail.
These are the people you need to speak to. Station manager for TfL there.
and the lady driver who drove the first train in.
I'm surrounded by several MTR staff, by some revenue protection people, by what looked like some BTP, land sheriffs, right. So up there, there's a poster, and it has given a clue as to what the tube map might look like between Iver and Reading. There's a sign saying outside fare zones, check tfl.gov.uk fares, and that's to do with the whole contactless bank cards are valid, but Oyster cards aren't. We got to Reading, we've come in on platform 13. Oh, there's a cross country in on 15. I'm trying to work out whether we'll go back out on 13. Will it sit here or will it... Does anybody know what time back out it's at? It is going to stand here for just a few minutes and go back out. I think it's the 9... What does the dot matrix say? It's either 9.48 or 9.49, and I will ride it all the way back to Paddington.
Next station, Maidenhead. Change for National Rail Services.
So back on the purple train, the third one of the day. There are three in the morning and three in the evening. Let me explain with my bit of paper. I shall put up an on-screen graphic now as well. So until the 15th of December for the next 3 weeks, it's three in the morning off of Reading. And I've got the 7.32 this morning. I got off at Slough, came back again, and I'm now on the 9.48 out of Reading back down to Paddington. And this evening, it's interesting to note that the one out of Paddington only goes as far as Maidenhead, then back to Paddington, and then goes all the way through to Reading. So those are the six. But then, as I say, as of Sunday, December the 15th onwards, it becomes proper TfL Rail, and TfL Rail and the Purple Trains take over all the stopping services, except for in the peak, there will still be some additional, I think, two an hour in the morning peak and two in the evening run by GWR.
So we're on the approach, it's 10.38, we're arriving into Paddington. I'm not gonna do the three this evening, I'm gonna go home and snooze and have an edit of this video. Arriving into, are we on time, chaps? Are we on time? There's some people here checking the times. Are we on time? Quick, check all the apps. You think we're coming on 9? We think we're coming in on platform 9.
Six minutes early?
What? And we're at Paddington. How was it?
Yeah, all good.
So that is it. That's your first ever purple train service in service running today, Monday the 25th of November. 3 in the morning, 3 in the evening, and then on Sunday, December the 15th, they'll be all day, every day. Crossrail, Elizabeth Line, Purple Train. It is coming, slowly. This is one step further towards it getting there.